Hey guys, this is a short schematic video on the boombox I created just a year or two ago and so forth. So basically, I have one battery here. This is the 12 volt 8 amp battery. As you can see, the red wire is the positive. The black down there has a common star ground. We're going through a 10 amp fuse on top here. Here, all right, better focus there. We do have charging that comes in through there. It's a USA 12 volt battery charger. Does trickle charge and so forth, very low current. Comes in on the other side, goes positive green all the way through a power switch there. And let's see what else is coming through here. We have also power coming in on the lapi amplifier. We have four wires for the speakers that go all the way up. Those are just 6.5 inch Polk DB651s. They are 4 ohms. The amp is a 20 watt stereo amplifier, T-class. And then a recent change, which has been a while actually, is the Bluetooth module that you see on the left. It is powered by a pair of 3.7 volt lithium-ion batteries that I have to pull out and charge once in a while, but each one is approximately 1300 milliamps and they last forever. Really, I only charge them like once a quarter, once every 3 months or so. And the 12 volt battery gets charged maybe about once a month. It's all based on my usage, which is just moderate. So these batteries last for a long time. And then the signal from the Bluetooth, as you can see, goes from right there. It's a 3.5 millimeter stereo. Goes through a little bundle over here. And eventually goes into two input jacks. You have one, which is that one there, which is coming from the Bluetooth module. And these pair of stereo RCAs actually come out through the top right there, where there's an input jack right there. And the switch is obviously, one is for the amp itself right there, and this one is for the Bluetooth module.
Power on. Phone 2 connected.
There's also just a really quick simple 12 volt battery monitor that's on the other side. Displays it. Sorry, it's upside down. 12.83 volts. At least it gives me an idea of the state of the battery and charge. When it gets down about just around 12.0 or slightly over 12 volts, I'll charge it. 12.8, 12.9 seems to be full charge. Okay, here is the other build. This is the Pelican 1050 case based. This also has a T-class amp. This one over here has the lapi 20 watt stereo amp there. This one is a Parts Express 15 watt, which is still a T-class and it runs very, very clean. Okay, so I have on the top view, there is the on-off rotary switch. Turns on a blue light in the front. That blue light LED is the power going to the 15 watt T-class amplifier. And this guy is the on-off button for the same Parts Express. Bluetooth module, which is a receiver. This is the top of the
connected.
This is the top of the port. Bluetooth module works really well. It, basically, you turn it on, and it once you pair it, it recognizes your iPhone, Android phone, whatever Bluetooth music player that you have. Okay, here's the inside. We'll start with the batteries. These batteries have to be taken out to charge, and these batteries are, man, they're just super capacity. They have tons of charge. Each one is a 3.7 volt, I believe it's a Panasonic lithium battery, roughly about 2900 milliamps of power. So the first two right there that you see, one, two, and then this one. These are all wired in series for almost 12 volts that powers this T-class amp right here. And then this last one is powering the Bluetooth module, which is sitting right there. I don't know if you can see it. Let's get up a little closer. Yeah, there it is. And I've basically soldered the power going right into it. We'll continue on with the Bluetooth. You can see that it has a on-off on light right there. And it is soldered wired. Let's focus a little bit better. Don't know if you can see it, but if you follow this line here all the way up, it goes into a 3.5 millimeter stereo input into this 15 watt T-class amp. And this Parts Express amp also comes with a ribbon cable, small little circuit board for the rotary on, off, and volume control. And then wiring these pair of 2.5 inch full range aluminum cone speakers are pretty self-explanatory. So it just comes from the printed circuit board, which I just soldered directly off of there. It goes directly into the speakers. There is an optional 12 volt power supply plug there that you can wire in, but I've opted to solder directly in from these three batteries, 1, 2, 3, for 12 volts. And it looks like it's all in series, but I've altered these battery holders so that these three here are just 12 volts for the T-class amp, and then this 3.7 volts is good enough to power this 5 volt nominally powered Bluetooth module. And 3.7 certainly works. Its range is certainly somewhere between 3.5 to slightly over 5 volts. So just a quick note about construction. I've pretty much used as many fasteners, harbor fasteners, screws, and nuts as possible. Carefully drill, measure 3 times, and cut once, hopefully. I used actually a lot of hot glue. Hot glue came in handy with mounting plenty of items. Definitely the Bluetooth modules, you might not be able to see it, but if I flip this over, shut it up, you can certainly tell that